in the, this is my back door, right? Salam alaikum. And good afternoon. Ya Muhammad, Dr. Haji Ahmad bin Kadir Maslam, the Deputy Minister of Finance, Malaysia. Ya Mahajiya, Dr. Chan, our strong supporter of Muslim world, distinguished members from Price, His Ambassador's Excellency, ladies and gentlemen. Shukr alhamdulillah, a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of us gathered here today to witness the launching of the fourth OIC World Peace, formerly known as the Muslim World Peace, Business and Investment Zone. The BIS stands for the Business and Investment Zone. Yes, don't ask me what's the meaning of the BIS. It stands for Business and Investment Zone. Okay. Of which will incorporate the second OIC Asia Trade Economic Forum in collaboration with the Islamic Center for Development of Trade and organ of the OIC organization and Arab League. I would like to express my sincere appreciation to our guest of honor, Yang Berhormat Dr. Ahmad Maslan, Deputy Minister, Ministry of Finance Malaysia, for taking time off from the very busy schedule to be with us today. Thank you, Yang Berhormat. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure that we bring you the fourth OIC World Peace, formerly known as the Muslim World Peace, a business investment zone, which will be held for the fourth time on the 25th to 28th September 2013, right here at the Putra World Trade Center. For information, last year, this event was successfully hosted in Jakarta with about 35 countries took part, and total business transacted close to 500 billion based on record given by the card in Jakarta. Inshallah, this year we expect double the figure. With aim to making Malaysia the hub of Islamic trade, the OIC World Peace Business Investment Zone is a groundbreaking platform for the global Islamic business to meet, interact, and transact deals with major partnership investment. The four-day event comprising of trade, education, Islamic banking, alcohol insurance, tourism, as well as exhibition. We should have participation from a wide range of international sellers, buyers, corporations, trade organizations, and associations. Other than the corporate services, many other OIC member countries were taking part in the terms of as a pavilion. This year, the event theme is enriching the borderless economy, where the government and corporation across the global converge to strengthen and widen their economy towards greater collaboration and closer relation among the Muslim business community and the rest of the world. As such, the 57 OIC member countries stand to benefit greatly from renewed emphasis on development and enhancement in business, In business network, as mentioned in four OIC World Peace, the event is poised to be one of the most leading trade shows dedicated to transform Malaysia into the global business hub. In short, Malaysia is also becoming the global leader in the various fields and serving as a strategic link within the Muslim world. Resources rich, emerging market, and high growth wealth areas, the active partnership between governments and the private sectors domestically, together with the multinational companies in globally. Malaysia is starting to becoming the regional net global champions, extending the One Malaysia, the Truly Asia brand is far beyond just the tourism sector. In the year 2011, ladies and gentlemen, Malaysia recorded the highest world foreign trade among the OIC countries. That shows under the premiership of Dato' Sri Najib, he has adopted an extensive, friendly approach to the world. The local corporate guys have benefited and expanded business to the rest of the world. Malaysia is also leading its place among the top 10 OIC member countries contributing trade growth for the Muslim economy based on the Times of Foreign Trade reported 2011, Malaysia recorded the highest world foreign trade amount to be 460 billion, followed by Saudi Arabia, 381 billion, Turkey 376 billion, Iran 225 billion, Nigeria 160 billion, Qatar 126 billion, Kuwait 109 billion, Algeria 105 billion. The 10 countries accounted for 73 of the world trade of the OIC member countries. By 2015, the OIC will be the biggest event on the planet. In this respect, we believe the trade will reach to 20%, which is the essential target set for the year 2015 by the OIC. The highlight of this event will be the Jewels of the Muslim World Award. The prestigious award, in conjunction with the OIC World Biz, is welcomed by many Muslim countries within the OIC in collaboration with the OIC, in collaboration with the International Islamic Center of Commerce in Jeddah, and ICDT, the organ of OIC, and the award is honored by OIC Today magazine, a business and USA magazine, the recipient of from those personalities who illustrate background on their captains of industries in the various fields of governance, education, science, financial institutions, commerce, trade sectors from all parts of the world. One of the important criteria is to those who contribute economies for the Muslim world. Just for information, ladies and gentlemen, last year, 2012, the recipient in Indonesia was one of the famous personalities, that's Prince Al-Walid, recipient, one of the recipients last year, and also followed by Dato' Sri Nazir, the CME CEO, and definitely my good friend, Dato' Hassan Khan, of Takwa Malaysia, and the IDB President, Tan Sri Muhammad Ali, and also another prominent figure from UK, Muhammad Auchi, and lastly, Tan Sri Anwar Ali. Those are recipients for last year. And for the exhibition, will be held at Hall 3 and 4, will accommodate about 400 booths. We expect about 300 local exhibitors, and the rest taken by foreign countries, especially from the OIC countries, CIS countries, Arab, Africa, Asia, European Union, UK, and US. This will establish a platform for exhibitors to bring into the non-traditional market, as well as to engage into a business matching, networking at international level. For the two-day second OIC Asia Trade Economic Forum, will be held at the Ballroom at Sri Pacific Hotel. The forum aims to promoting trade investment flows between the Arab and Asian countries, member states of the OIC, identifying the evolution of the current status of the trade investment and the possible prospects in the Arab and Asian countries, in the light, on one hand, of the establishment of the Greater Arab Free Trade under the Framework Agreement on the Trade Preferential System among the OIC member countries, or we call it DPC or OIC, and then will be established a free trade areas among them and other enhanced trade investment between them. Ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, in an effort to increase and expand the Muslim world market, an organized effort has to be carried out to educate and to promote the Muslim product as well as the hidden treasure culture of the Muslim world. The OIC country that are unknown to the world. I believe strongly that both the OIC World Biz and the OIC Asia Forum is an appropriate initiative toward this objective. Therefore, we would like your participation, involvement to see that this event will be very successful. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank to your Bhagia, Dato' Maslam, for your presence here, to grace this wonderful event here. And in fact, I just want to share something very important here. The OIC, the Muslim World Biz, used to be the for the past 4 years, we've called the Muslim World Biz. And after so long, 20 years, that OIC International has been very aggressively promoting this event. And last year, the OIC called us up and they have to really make endorsement and said that no other company, no other in the world that's going very aggressively promoting intra-trade among the Muslim world. And they recognize, acknowledge the OIC International is one of the right platform to do a joint collaboration. So we have signed a quite number of framework last year, November in Casablanca, and also last year to November in Johor Bahru, WF. So you've got 20 items to be succeed in next 5 years. So I think the most important here, the Malaysian company has been acknowledged by international organization. With this, the credit should go to the Malaysian organization. Definitely with our Prime Minister Najib, he played a very important role. I think you must see, like, compared to Pakistan, if compared to Indonesia, Pakistan really about 180 million population. And to Indonesia, Saudi by 80 million population, UAE, and all the countries, they still lose to Malaysian trade. So Malaysia is the number one highest trading to the world 2011. This shows our Prime Minister Najib has played a very important role to give the freedom, friendly approach to the local guys in order for them to be playing a very important role to increase the intra-trade. So the credit goes to the current government. I think we'd like to congratulate you, give a big applause to the Prime Minister for making such a friendly approach to the world body. Thank you very much once again. Wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.